gusto na, first, i-clarify na ako na kanang reintegration, ang goal, Anna, is to make them productive citizens sa ilaha mga komunidad. Kung kanang imuhang mga population na gina-mention are persons, these persons deprived of liberty originally offended Section 5, pushing, and 11, possession. O niya, because of the plea bargain, kaya para makalusot sila, kaya non-bail ba yan ang 5, na gina-reduce ang ilahang offense to Section 15. So you see, mona ma-rehab sila. And the reason, we give them treatment, no, accordingly to the levels of dependency, whether low, moderate, or severe. Now, ang mong ginasulti is ang katunganon silang nag-repeat offense. Despite na ang support systems of government is in place, the healthcare is free, welfare is provided. So there are two things. One, we're not just dealing with the repeat offenders who are only focusing to drugs. Lagi sila sakit sa isip. Okay? So we call this antisocial personality patterns or traits. Ruled out yan by the study conducted by the San Pedro County.
Di ba niya effect sa use?
Effect sa drugs? Uh-huh. Hindi din. It could be an effect of the drug or it could be naanagi sila sakit sa isip. Okay? Aggravated by the drugs. Pwede ganyan, Anna. Okay. So the other thing is, since the systems of care are in place, pero kulang ta sa tao in terms of managing the cases. This study actually pointed out the lack of caseload control dito sa pag-manage cases. How many social workers do we have? We only have 120. Sa 182 barangay ka na ilahang ginaatiman. So pag abot sa silong, pinaka PDL ang ilahang ginahandle. So mas short change tong quality sa case manage because there is no policy in caseload control. Walay basihan ang welfare office to hire more people because they always claim that generally silang approach, ilahatanan, pagpanganak, hantos kamatay, sa paglungong ilahang dalahon. Ang suggestion sa study na ni is establish caseload control. Like there says, di ba, dili sila pwede mag more than how many numbers of patients. Correct ba, Doc Apple? You call that caseload control. Muna yung missing dito sa case management na to. The case management principle is there theoretically in the books. You can find it there. Kung unsagid ang iyang quality where you can say, maayo ang case management. But in terms of actual implementation, we don't have enough people. You know why? Walay policy.
So kailangan na ay legislation.
Kung masinibang sihan mag-hire. It should be the same with the health system. Kasi si health system na siya para professional like the barangay social workers, barangay nutrition scholars. Mm. They're the enumerators of the doctors. Mm-hmm. Wala enumerator at mga social workers. Sila ta na magdarag. Bit-bit na sila feedback everything dito sa community. Kulang ang tao sa office na yan. Luipod sila. Because sila ginabumbahan sa kadili maayong mahitabo sa tao. Just because they're not hiring enough people.
So, ang kung mga nagkaroon ni Gawas is, di ba, nagabalik-balik sila. Mm-hmm. And then sometimes, it's because they have that kind of kanyang mental disorder. Or,
yes.
Mental disorder na sometimes na...
That are not properly addressed.
Oo.
Because we only... Ang atong treatment is just the substance. Mm. Lagi man ang treatment sa thinking disorder.
Mapod na.
So, maputoy wala nakitaan because although... we're trying to harmonize the courts and the executive kita, no, sa kanaan LGU. Because part supposedly ng drug dependency examination is the neuropsychological test. Pero kung reviewin mo tanang drug dependency examination sa tanang nag-repeat offense, no issue sa mental health tanang. Wala nila gibuhat ang NPT.
Okay, ang nigawas mo karon sa di ba nag-repeat offense light tapos nakita din
because the condition is not addressed. Lahi man ang treatment sa isip, sir.
May mental condition tapos mo enforce si police, nya musuko sa police, ini si police.
Dito lagi as defense, kayo, mura tayo nag-recycle people who have mental
issues. Balik-balik siya, recurring siya na issue na pag mapatay sa police, it's because of their mental disorder, pasangilan na po ng police. Oh, di ba, murag, I think we are just only cutting the branches but not the roots of the problem.
Yes, I think this is the relevance of the study because it's giving a new viewpoint for the courts to understand how important dili lang si ang korte magulat sa decision sa doktor sa level of dependency, kundi tanawan doon niya ang neuropsychological condition sa tao in order for us to come up with an appropriate intervention.
So, this proves na lalong yun ang problem. Lalong. Sa
look at the study, I've shared it with you, it's published, so please appreciate it.
Kay Attorney Myung or kay Dr. Apple, your rejoinder po sa statement ni Sir Ronald. Yes, ma'am, yun po.
Yung actually, the need talaga is to for doctors to actually assess the patient if the problem is only substance abuse or it includes psychiatric disorder. Doctors diagnose illnesses basing on the DSM-5, that's the latest. So it has this diagnostic criteria to be able to identify what is the problem of the patient or the drug abuser. Now, we have this so-called co-occurring illness. At times, a person may have substance abuse and at the same time, schizophrenia. So this is what we call dual diagnosis. So some patients are admitted primarily because of drug abuse. But at times, when they are already admitted, symptoms will appear like the same with the symptoms of substance abuse, like hallucination, delusion, it's the same. Substance abusers will come to a point of having hallucinations. Schizophrenia will also have hallucinations. So they would think it's the same, when in fact, it is a co-occurring illness. So we treat in the rehabilitation center the drug abuse, but we forgot to treat also schizophrenia. So I think it's best that there should be proper assessment so that we can target what needs to be treated. We don't only focus on drug abuse because there might be co-occurring illnesses. I have so many patients in the rehabilitation center that are diagnosed with substance abuse, but later on, it was diagnosed with schizophrenia at the same time. So I think we need to look into what actually are the interventions for the substance abusers. We also have to base it scientifically so that we can provide actual or the actual need of the patient. We have to remember that not all substance abusers has the same treatment. Not all substance abusers have to be treated like the way you treated patient A and then patient B, patient C, because they have different needs. So again, we go back to assessment and then we have to target what is the need of the person.
On the part of Kaid, sa ano ma'am, ano bang anong ginagawa niyo no to somehow no parang address this kind of problem, or ano ba formulating pa a solution kay kakalabasan
na like before we already have formulated like yung ating organ ICMC. Meron po kami process na we follow upon knowing if the student is positive. So meron po kami proseso, pero hindi ko po dala. But if we have this included in the program is to refer the student if there are other co-occurring illness to an institution. If for rehabilitation or for community-based rehabilitation, we have the process that we follow.
Lasa lang kay Attorney Myung. Attorney Myung, on the legal process po, unsa are you going to recommend no for policy making itong study nga gikandak sa San Pedro College? San Pedro College pa, sir?
Yes.
Well, every policy must be based on research. Dapat evidence based ato ang proposal for policies. I have not read the report yet of the study, but if in case that we will find out that there is a sound argument there for a policy support, why not? We will advocate for any policy. But on the part of Sir Ronald, ba sina mo nakita nga policy implications sa study?
We are seeing the gap kasi si guideline ng court comes from the Supreme Court, equal branch of government. Kita sa executive, sa local government, let the guideline, Department of Justice, Dangerous Drugs Board, you cannot, dangerous drugs board cannot tell the court what to do. Bitugi siya sa rules of court. So that's why there's another avenue, it's called the Justice Coordinating Council. It is being led by the Supreme Court. In order for us to put into the, to harmonize the two equal branch of government. Okay, I will tell you, ang court musulti, pag ikaw found to be in possession or na nagamit ka droga, i-drug test kita. That's the first instruction, maling-mali yun in the beginning. And then it evolved to, sige, I will ask you to have to undergo a drug dependency test, maligya pa ng term, until it became drug dependency examination. A drug dependency examination, ang expanse nito, it considers education, the mental health status, the livelihood, everything. The breadth of the severity, lahat ng areas are considered. Unfortunately, yun pa rin ang tinitingnan ni court. The basis of the treatment or the court order kung sa imuhang treatment is according to the drug dependency exam. Unfortunately, as we reviewed all the DDEs, dito sa mental health status, wala nila giklaro. Wala nila gibuhat. Or it was that in the eye of the court, hindi lang ako concerned. Basta kay, naakay drug dependency level, then I will mag-court order ko nga matreatment ka. In the algorithm of the wellness flow prescribed by the Dangerous Drugs Board in the Department of Health, if the person has a co-occurring disorder as shared by Dr. Apple, dili ka diretso mag-rehab, i-address sa through a specialized facility. You are categorically termed as a mentally ill chemical abuser. I-address muna yung structural or thinking problems. Kasi yun ang mental health. May problema sa brain, may problema sa isip, magkaiba yun. At may problema sa substance and they overlap and are correlated. So tama yung sabi ni ma'am, appropriateness of intervention. But kulang tayo sa diagnostics. The correct diagnostics para makarule out tayo ng proper treatment with respect to kung ano man ang rule out ng diagnosis.
Although naka-rejoinder ko sa pangutana ganina nga nung ang uban when it comes to reintegration, mabalik sila. Kaning mga cases of relapse, nga nung nagkakita mo na. Well, we have underscored ganina nga ang problema sa droga, lalong uglapad. That is given na. Tapos, on our part, as an academic institution, we can only do so much. Our resources are finite, limitado po na mong resources, so we cannot do everything we want to do. Having said that, ang amuang healing and recovery of drug surrenders, we do it in a way nga nakafocus magmi sa supply side, not on the demand side. Sa demand side, we nakafocus and not on the supply side. As far as the demand side is concerned, among ginapakusgan nga dapat ang reform program sa usa ka drug dependent must not only be focused on the drug reformist himself or herself. As ana gani sila, it takes a village to save a soul. Kumbaga dili lang ang programa nato, proyekto nato nakatutok dito sa drug reformist, but we also cover the community, ang mga relatives niya, ang mga friends niya, ang mga kamag-anak niya. Kaya once na ma-reform mo ang individual, umbalik siya ang komunidad, nakugihapon ang temptasyon na itukmod siya sa droga, umbalik gihapon siya. So dapat, ato pong reform, not only an individual, but reform the entire community. That's what we are doing in our HERDS program. And as far as I know, sa mong HERDS program, very low ang percentage sa mga cases of relapse, katong nagabalik sa drugs. I think, I can say nga I can confidently say nga murag effective ang inahimo sa HERDS program kay wala man kay nag-relapse kanang effort gani to extend the program, to extend the intervention not only to the individual level but also to the community where he is involved.
Okay, thank you po. Pasan mo ako, Tech.